the ability to just make materials that can change into any shape you want is pretty exciting. You know, I think a lot of people know the movie Flubber.
There you go.
And it's a soft material that can change shape. In a way, we're trying to achieve that. We're not quite there yet, but I think we got one step closer.
So this one will take a little bit longer, but you'll see it start to go flat on the edges first because it's the black surface is heating up faster.
So I work with liquid crystal elastomers. So this is liquid crystals embedded into a polymer network that feels similar to what a rubber band is in terms of how strong it is and how stretchy it is. And these are the same liquid crystals that you find in your LCD TVs or calculator screens. So liquid crystals are all around you. And what we're doing here is we're embedding it into this polymer network.
So that's the liquid crystal molecules all orienting.
We're able to control the shape of the material on a molecular level.
And so what's happening when you heat this material is the liquid crystals are transitioning into a non-liquid crystal phase, into just a disordered phase.
So these transition at around 80 degrees C.
It's a phase change and it's completely reversible. You can heat it up, it'll change shape. You cool it back, it goes back to where it started.
So I think there's lots of potential applications. So one is people always want tactile buttons for their smartphones. So if you can have something that starts off, that's low weight, that's initially a flat sheet, and then can pop out buttons, that could be useful for many different devices. Or you can think of sort of for braille displays for the visually impaired.
There are a lot of biomedical applications being explored. So people are looking at, for example, if you grow cells in a scaffold of these materials and you have this material change shape and actuate during that cell growth, the cells will feel that and they'll respond to that and they'll grow in different ways. And so there's potential there for tissue and cellular engineering.
This could also be useful in lots of biomedical applications, where if you're implanting in something into the body changes, it grows and contracts as, say, blood is pumped through a vessel. So if you're able to have implantable material that's soft, similar to the mechanics of natural human tissue, that can also grow and expand with the body, that could be very beneficial. So a lot of these applications are very far off, but one of the key pieces that needed to be found was being able to program any shape we need easily. And so that's kind of the piece of the puzzle that we've been working on here, is figuring out if we want whatever shape to happen, to go from some unknown shape A to unknown shape B, we can do that pretty easily now.